Okay, so let's solve this problem. So to find the derivative of trigonometric functions, and these are the formulas, then for this given, so to find the derivative, so for this given, u is equal to 4x, and for the derivative of u, so du is equal to 4. Then to find now the derivative of this given function, since cosine, and for the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so we have negative sine, then u, and u is 4x, then times the derivative of u, and the derivative of u is 4. Then we need to write first the constant, so we have negative 4, then sine 4x, so this is now the derivative. Then for this given, so for this given, u is 3x minus 4. And du, so the derivative of u, that's 3. Then to find now the derivative, since we have this constant, so just bring down this constant, then times the derivative of second, and the derivative of second is secant u times tangent u. So we have secant u, and u is 3x minus 4, then times tangent u, so tangent 3x minus 4, times du, and du is 3. Then we need to simplify the constant, so multiply this 5 times 3, and we need to write first the constant. So 5 times 3, this one is 15. Then we have second, 3x minus 4 times tangent, 3x minus 4. So this is now the derivative. Then for this given, to find the derivative, so just find the derivative for every terms. So for this term, u is 5x plus 3, and du, so du is 5. Then for this term, u is 2x minus 4, and du, so the derivative of u, that's 2. Then to find now the derivative for this given, so again, bring down this constant, then times the derivative of sine is cosine. So we have cosine 5x plus 3 times the derivative of u, so times 5. Then minus, bring down this constant, so minus 2, then times the derivative of cotangent, that's negative cosecant squared u, so negative cosecant squared in u, u is 2x minus 4 times du, and du is 2. Then to simplify, so multiply the constant, so we have 3 times 5, this one is 15. Then cosine 5x plus 3, then this negative 2 times 2, that's negative 4, and negative 4 times negative, so negative times negative, that's positive, so this is positive 4. Then cosecant squared 2x minus 4, so this is now the derivative. Then for this given, so if the function contains an exponent, So for this given, we're going to use the general power formula. And the general power formula, so we have u to the power n, and to find the derivative, so this is n times u to the power n minus 1 times the derivative of u. So this is the general power formula. Then for this given, so first we need to rewrite this given, so we just need to put the exponent outside. So this is equal to tangent then 2x minus 7 quantity to the power 3. Then using now this general power formula to find the derivative, so we have u to the power n, that's equal to n, and n is equal to 3, then tangent 2x minus 7, then n minus 1, so 3 minus 1, so to the power 2, then times du, and du is the derivative of this equation inside the parentheses. So for du, first, the derivative of tangent, and the derivative of tangent is second squared u. So we have second squared in u is 2x minus 7 times du, or the derivative of 2x minus 7. So that's 2. Then to simplify, so multiply this 3 times 2. So 3 times 2, that's 6. Then we have tangent. Then we need to put this exponent to tangent. Then 2x minus 7. Then times second squared. 2x minus 7. So this is now the derivative. Then for this given, so again using the general power formula, but first we need to rewrite this given. So this is equal to sine 3x then to the power 2. Then to find the derivative, so using the general power formula, so we have n, and n is 2, then times sine 3x then to the power n minus 1, so that's equal to 1, then times du, or the derivative of sine 3x, so the derivative of sine, that's cosine, so this is cosine u, or cosine 3x, times the derivative of u, or the derivative of 3x, so that's 3. Then we need to multiply the constant, so 2 times 3, that's 6. Then we have sine 3x times cosine 3x. Then for the final answer, since we have an identity for the sine times cosine and the same angle, so using the double angle identity, that 2 sine A cosine A, this is equal to sine 2A. So this is the double angle identity for sine. So for this equation, using this double angle identity, so all you have to do is to divide by 2 the number outside, then times 2 the sine angle. And take note that we can only use this double angle identity for sine if that functions is the product of sine and cosine, so sine times cosine. So if we have this given 8 sine 2x then cosine 2x, so using this identity, so again, divide by 2 the number outside. So 8 divided by 2, that's 4, then sine, times 2 the sine angle. So 2x times 2, this one is 4x. So this is now the double angle identity for sine. For this equation, to find the final answer using this double angle identity for sine, so again, divide by 2, the number outside, so 6 divided by 2, that's 3, then sine, and times 2 for the sine angle, so 3 times 2, that's 6x, so this is now the derivative. Then for this given, so cosine 5x minus 2 over cotangent 5x minus 2. So if the given the same angles, then we need to check if there is an identity using this figure. And from this figure, so this is sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, second and cosecant, and this is 1. So using this figure to find the identity for this given, so if we have cotangent over cosecant, the identity is cosine, and for secant over cosecant, the identity is tangent. Then if we have sine over tangent, then the identity is cosine, or if you have secant over tangent, then the identity is cosecant. So for this given, cosine over cotangent, so cosine over cotangent, so the identity is sine. So therefore, this equation is equal to sine 5x minus 2. Then to find now the derivative using this given, so u is 5x minus 2 and du, that's 5. Then to find now the derivative, so the derivative of sine, that's cosine. So this is cosine u, and u is 5x minus 2 times du, and du is 5. So we have now y prime equals 5. So we need to write the constant first, then cosine 5x minus 2. So this is now the derivative. Then for the product of two functions, so using this figure to find the identity, then take note that this is sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, secant, and cosecant. So when you multiply the two functions, the result is the middle function. So if we have cosine times cosecant, so the result is the middle function. Then for tangent times cosecant, so the result or the identity is secant. And for tangent times cosine, so the identity is sine. Then for sine times cotangent, and the identity is cosine. So for this given, sine times secant, sine times secant, so the identity is tangent. So therefore, this given is equal to tangent 4x plus 3. Then to find now the derivative, so u is 4x plus 3, and du, so the derivative of u, that's 4. Then to find now the derivative, since the derivative of tangent is secant squared, so we have secant squared u, 4x plus 3, times du, and du is 4. Then again, we need to write first the constant. So we have 4, then second squared, 4x plus 3. So this is now the derivative. Then for this given, so again, if the product of sine and cosine and the same angle, then we're going to use the double angle identity for sine. So for the double angle identity for sine, so that's sine 2a, and the formula, so divide by 2, the number outside, so 3 divide by 2, this one is 3 over 2, then sine times 2, the sine angle, so 4x times 2, that's 8x. Then to find now the derivative, so u is 8x and du is 8. Then we have y prime, so bring down the constant, then times the derivative of sine, and the derivative of sine is cosine, so cosine 8x times du times 8. Then to simplify, so multiply this 3 over 2 times 8. So we have y prime equals, so multiply this 3 times 8. So 3 times 8 is 24, then over 2. Then cosine 8x, then reduce. So this 24 divided by 2, this one is 12. Then cosine 8x. So this is now the derivative.